No matter what you're going through, I know that you can stand. for your life is in his hands. Listen.
No matter what you're going through.
His grace and mercy endure forever. He loves you. I know it.
Hallelujah. Young people, there's nothing wrong with dancing for Jesus. But we can't forget where we come from. So if you don't mind, let's have a little church right now.
Something about that name.
Thank you, Jesus. Listen. Hallelujah. Yes,
yes, it is the sweetest
name.
I love the name.
Come on and lift your hands and say it.
It is the sweetest name.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know.
Listen to this right here.
Some people say I'm crazy, but I can't explain.
No, no.
The power that I feel, oh, when I call your name.
When I call your name.
Said it's just like fire. Oh, oh, shut up in my bones.
Oh, oh.
By the name.
No matter what you're going through, I know that you can stand. For your life is in His hand.
Don't you be afraid.
Joy cometh in the morning. troubles, they don't last always.
Troubles, they don't last always.
Ah, for there's a friend named
Jesus.
For
there's a friend named
Jesus. Who will wipe every tear.
Who will wipe your tears away.
And if your heart is broken.
And if your heart is
broken. Just lift those hands.
Just lift your hands.
Come on, sing it with me. I know I can.
Oh, I know that I can.
Bless your name, Jesus. No matter what may come my way,
no matter what may come my way,
my life
is in your
hands. Oh, hallelujah. With Jesus, I can take it.
With Jesus, I can take
it. I really love you, Jesus. With him.
With him, I know I can stand.
No matter what may come my way,
no matter what may come my way.
They seem to get you down.
They seem to get you down.
And all your friends and loved ones.
And all your friends and loved ones.
They're nowhere to be found.
Are nowhere to be found.
Remember, 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 there is a friend.
Remember, there's a friend in Jesus.
Oh, I love him, I love him.
Who will wipe your tears away.
I know he will. And if.
And if your heart is broken.
This is all you have to do.
Lift your hands.
Come on, and with me. Say it. Come on.
Oh, I know that I can make it.
Don't you give up. I know.
I know that I can stand.
Hang on, joy is coming. I know.
No matter what may come my way.
Jesus, my life.
My life is in.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. With him, I know I can take it.
Jesus, I can take it.
With him, I know. Some church in here. No matter
no
what.
Matter what
yeah, 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 yeah. Jesus, my life is in.
My life is in your hands.
Every person that's going through, lift your hands and say with me. I know I can.
I know that I can.
I got a witness in here somewhere. I know.
I know that I can.
Hallelujah. No matter what may come my way.
No matter what may come my way.
Jesus, my life is in. Oh, I love you so much, Jesus. With you, I know I can.
With Jesus, I can take it.
Oh, bless your name, Jesus.
With him, I know I can stand.
No matter what may come my way.
No matter what may come my way.
Hallelujah.
My life is in your hands.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's hear it with me. I know.
I know that I can make it.
I know you can make it. I know you can.
I know that
no matter what may come my way, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. With him, I know I can take it.
Jesus,
I feel him all in my spirit right now. I feel him.
Thank you, Jesus.
No matter what may come my way,
no matter what may come my way.
Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. No matter what you're going through, his grace and mercy do it for her. He loves you. I know it does. Hallelujah. Young people, there's nothing wrong with dancing for Jesus. But we can't forget where we come from. So if you don't mind, let's have a little church right now.
Something about that name.
Thank you, Jesus. Listen.
Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name Jesus.
Hallelujah. Yes,
yes, it is the sweetest name.
Sweetest name I know. I love the name Jesus.
Oh, I love the
name.
lift your hands and say
it is the sweetest name.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know.
Listen to this right here.
Some people say I'm crazy, but I can't explain.
No, no.
The power that I feel, when I call your name.
When I call your name.
Said it's just like shut up in my bones.
Oh,
yeah, the Holy Ghost is moving here.
Yes, it is.
And it just won't leave me alone. Oh, there's something, yeah.
Something about the name,
yes, it is.
Something about the name.
Oh, I'll be alive.
It is the sweet.
I love the name.
Oh, how I
Seems like you can't make it. Will you please stand for the processional as we celebrate the life and legacy of Supervisor Ruth Trotter, Eiland.
I just knew how to have church. Our hearts are heavy, the tears are flowing, we're saddened, but in that great yet in the morning. She is already telling the saints, don't be sad for me. I've got my reward. I'm going to invite every person this morning to let's have some church in honoring Supervisor Ruth Trotter Eiland. Is that all right? Oh, bless his name. God's got a blessing for you. Oh, God's got a blessing for you. On the life of this wonderful woman of God. Amen. Lady Ruth Trotter Eiland. One more time. Let's celebrate her life. We give her a great cup this year. Come on. A life well lived. We honor God today, certainly for the age of this house. Amen. Thank you, Bishop Walker, for allowing us to celebrate in this building. We thank God for the jurisdiction of heaven. Amen. The Bishop Anthea Will, amen, Texas Northeast 4th jurisdiction. We appreciate, amen, his leadership. We thank God for these jurisdictional bishops all the way from Ohio. Bishop Edward Cook, who is the mentor and the pastor of Superintendent Eiland. I met him years ago. He was just a superintendent. And we became friends, I don't know, 25 years ago. But he was just a superintendent. Now God has elevated him to bishop, and we honor him today, the mentor of Superintendent Eiland, Bishop Cook, in Ohio, in the northern jurisdiction. And thank God for my jurisdiction, the leading bishop, the Bishop James E. Hornsby, takes the Northeast first jurisdiction. I have served many years under Bishop Haynes. And certainly honor Bishop, amen, the one and only Bishop Reginald Wayne, Reginald Williams. God preached the preaching man. Preaching machine. God has blessed him. He looked great. These other bishops, God bless you today on the platform. Bishop Jackson, God bless you. Today we come to celebrate, and I want you to, I'm not going to say take your shoes off. I'm going to say let's have church. Amen. The service has been printed, and unless Superintendent Eiland instructs me, the service is printed and will go the way it's printed. I am the MC, but I'm following his leadership and the leadership of jurisdictional leader, Bishop Nathaniel Wells. I'm going to ask everybody to stand except the family and receive prayer from Elder Pastor Ernest Dunbar. And the scripture reading will be coming from Old Testament. Elder Michael Jones. Amen. They call him Big Mike. New Testament Pastor Antonio Budden. These men, Elder Jones and Pastor Budden, came under the tutelage of Superintendent.
for her passions far above rubies. The heart of her husband does safely trust in her. So he shall have no need of more. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. May the hearing doers of God's word continue to be blessed.
I will be reading your hearers from the book of John, chapter 11, verse 25 to 26. Jesus said unto Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this?
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. God bless the prayer and these scripture readings. Amen. All of us can say something about Supervisor Eiland. These men on the platform, each one can say something about her. And certainly we honor today these women of God. Mother Parker, God bless you. Jurisdictional Supervisor, God bless you. Mother Barnes, all the way from Houston, Texas. God bless you. Lubbock, Texas. Amen. Texas Northwest. Mother Bishop, amen. And Watson, and she's here representing Mother Barbecue Lewis for this morning. All of us can say something about, amen, Mother Eiland. From the smallest to the greatest, she can identify with anybody on every level. And look around today, see this influx of support. Some are still in the hallways and standing. And I'm going to ask this time if Bishop Nathan D.D. Wells, President of Texas Northeast 4th Jurisdiction, will come and have special remarks about this wonderful lady. When you met Mother Eiland, you met somebody that left an indelible imprint upon your life in eternity. And she could cook. Oh, she could cook. But can she cook, y'all? How many of y'all traveled with her? How many of y'all went on a trip with her, other than the family? How many of y'all traveled? Stand, you went on a trip with Mother Eiland, not part of the family. You traveled with her on a cruise, on vacation. I see you back there. Amen. She organized trips. Amen. Pastor Eiland just showed up. He traveled several times on crew. I said, what kind of flight y'all catching? He said, I don't know, check with Ruth. He just showed up. But she was the glue. All of us can say something about her. I'm going to ask again this time Bishop Wells will come with special remarks. And following Bishop Wells, there'll be words of comfort coming from Bishop Edward T. Cook, President of Ohio North First Jurisdiction, and then followed by Bishop T.L. Walker, Straightway Pentecostal Cathedral, Church of God in Christ. And while we're honoring them, let's honor these First Ladies as well. First Lady Nathan Wells and First Lady Walker.
Looking at the word
words that you wrote concerning your life. And now all of the ladies that was in the yearbook, for some reason your eyes went to her. God, in his wisdom, always sets something in front of us to pull us to the person that is to be our life long mates. You were blessed. I was listening to Sister Jackson. She came and spoke for us in one of the women's services a number of years ago. And those words still resonate in my heart, how she talked about the flow of that water. And certainly, she has left a great legacy. Children, those of us that knew her, we feel and know that she knew God. More than anything, in this season, things that we go through, the trouble that seemed to befall us, isn't it good to know that she knew God? Somehow I'll give him praise, especially those of you that know him. We oftentimes don't understand this thing called death. And people will tell us, right now, a little bit too loud. People will tell us, please bring it down a little bit. People will tell us that they know how we think you feel. But nobody knows how you feel. God is one that will comfort you and give you strength through this season. We are praying for you and your family. God is still God. And I can come to the conclusion that ain't nobody God but God. Be God by himself. God bless you.
Through the fortune or the misfortune of Providence,
promotion to Dallas, Texas. It was one of the saddest days in the life of my entire church that the Eilands left. Amen. But nevertheless, we stayed in touch for the most part. And for many, many years, they were that couple that we met when we went to the national meetings. We saw them sometimes when they came to Ohio. That was a period in which they were just a fond memory, close but distant friends. And then there was a third in common. About a month and a half ago, I came to Dallas for the leadership conference.
And while here, suffered multiple strokes. And almost from the moment that I showed up at the emergency room, Roger Eiland was there. And for 18 days, my family, my wife, my daughter, and my grandson, and later myself, we spent in the home of the Eilands. I knew because of a previous encounter with Ruth that she had been diagnosed with cancer and was given the devil a fit in his attempt to try to inflict her. So I came with the purpose of encouraging her.
Yes.
No. Once again, she proved that she was Ruth Eiland, and that meant something. She and her relationship with God would not be encouraged, even though she received what we had to say, but she gave back more than she received. And she and Roger ministered to my wife and myself. And I learned so much about faith. You know, there's a lot of us that have faith in faith, and a few of us that have faith in God. Roger and Ruth have faith in God. And as a result, they literally could tell the devil, none of what you're doing is working. Amen. And so when a few days ago, I heard that they'd gone on to be with the Lord. And I want to defy all of those of you that use the phrase, the Lord took her.
Yeah.
No, he didn't. The Lord received her. And there was something extremely sad about the news, and at the same time, extremely joyous. For if there was anyone that lived to be with the Lord, you know, we use the scripture all the time, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Well, what Ruth taught me is that that scripture has nothing to do with death. Not physical death. That scripture has everything to do with your relationship with God the minute you give yourself to Him. Because you're no longer dictated to by your body. You're in the presence of the Lord, and you are there from the moment you go from death to life. And that's what happens when we get saved. The Lord takes us from death, because before you get saved, you're just the walking dead. It's very hard for me, and I apologize. I just messed up all of the protocol.
And I say that not because he convinced me to do anything. To succumb. And he invited me to church a day and a half after I got out of intensive care. And I was silently hoping he would, and silently hoping that he would be as convincing as I knew he could be, so that my wife and my daughter, who are my wardens, would make sure that, that they allowed me to go to church. And I did. And I went to Prayer Garden Church, East Prayer Garden, Prayer Tower, excuse me, Prayer Tower Church of God in Christ. And I cried during the whole service, because it was so much like the church that we remember that I pastored before the church I pastor now. And it was an experience that I absolutely positively needed at that moment. And if you think that as a preacher, as a bishop, I'm standing here rambling, you just don't understand. There is not enough words to say about Ruth Eiland. It's hard for me to even look at this program, because every picture is Ruth. The joy, the humor, the wittiness. She would have been a great comedian. She could say it with a straight face, have him cracking up. And then there were times she would crack up if you didn't crack up, because she knew it was funny. I didn't try to prepare anything, and that's pretty evident, because there's just no way to prepare to speak about someone who is as genuinely great as Bruce Lyle. The Trotter family. Amen. Well, anyway, I mean, it's time. I just want to say this to the family, to the husband. If you're not watching our team, to her daughters, to her son, to her sisters and brothers, and the host of cousins, nieces, and nephews that make up the Eiland/Trotter family. You had the privilege of knowing
Ruth for as long as you knew her. Counted a tremendous gift and blessing from God. Treated for what it is. An encounter with someone who left an indelible impression upon your life. Who spoke truth at all times, who lived what she spoke about, who died in victory, and who continues to live through the Spirit. She was truly a tremendous woman of God, and I'm going to miss her, but only for so long. Because you all keep telling me about this meeting they're going to have, this reunion they're going to have, and they say that, well, you won't be, there won't be marriage and all of that in heaven. Y'all don't know. You ain't never been there. I do know this: there will be a day in which those the dead in Christ shall rise. Amen. We shall see her again. And nobody that has died before me will get there before me. Amen. 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 She ain't in heaven yet. She can't get there till you get there. Amen. So please pray for me. Please pray for me.
Amen.
I did better than I thought I would. Because the truth impacted my life. I am soliciting your prayers. I love you, my love. I love this family. God bless you.
I'm glad to be here with my friend, Superintendent Eiland. I thank God for these pastors, Bishop Wells, Bishop Hornsby, Bishop Williams, Bishop Cook, our eulogist, and my other, your brother of the gospel, Bishop Jackson, all of you. I'm kind of at a loss of words because I didn't know Mother Eiland as long as some, but she became a very dear friend. I recall a few months ago, I was told I needed some rest. I was tired. And the superintendent, he always looked out for me. I believe it was her who made up her mind to say,
"You're going to take him where he can get some rest." And they took me to the Alamo City. And we were going to breakfast, lunch, we were going somewhere to eat. The curve was about to stop.
I stepped off the curve. Get my knee to the bone. They helped me get up. Mother Eiland got me to a restaurant, got bandages and wrapped my leg, asked me how I felt. And I told her all right, but I was sure hurt. And she looked out for me, she took care of me. And I appreciate the time that God gave me to know such a woman. The other day we were at her birthday celebration. I asked the question, not that I had forgotten anything, but who can find a virtuous woman that I can say, she was. Not long ago, I had the privilege of going
and we traveled from New York in a Jumbo 747. Well, if God would have it be before we reached Tel Aviv, we dealt with some turbulence. And I'm on there with all these bishops. I'm saying, "Lord, I sure hope they say."
She got a better offer.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Help put those tambourines down. We're going to praise them some more. We don't want to belabor the hour. I know we're having truth. Put that tambourine down. Put that tambourine down. Mr. Queen, told Twinkie. He said, Twinkie, don't touch that key. Don't touch that key, Brother Nation. Hallelujah. Brother Allen loves to have church. And oftentimes we visited Prayer Tower. And every time we went to Prayer Tower, it was always a joyous, celebratory moment. Mother Ida took the microphone and started singing. That was all, it was all she wrote. Amen. Thank you, thank you, thank you for those words. And Bishop Wells, Bishop Cook, and Bishop Walker. Now, I'm doing all I can to hold it together because the island, Sunan Island, amen, that's my best friend right there. That's my best friend. We have traveled together.
Didn't have a home to be, just stayed there. My mother was still living at the time, and they had this big, huge house. We got to Memphis, my mother put them in the
special guest room, and I had to go upstairs. And I woke up the next morning, I smelled coffee, Mother Parker, and I smelled bacon. I said, what's going on? I walked downstairs in my pajamas. Hear my mother at the table talking. She had fed him breakfast. I said, wait a minute, I'm your son. She said, your best friend is my son too. And so we took him in as a big brother. He's older than me, a few months. But your wife loved to have church, and we came to have church today. Lift you up, lift you up. Tina, Tara, Stephanie, and Roger. Listen, this choir is coming be on behalf of Bishop Wells. He wanted to personally apologize to Mother Parker, Mother Bonds, when he got up and he didn't recognize y'all, but he's getting a little older right now. He's getting older, crimson to his head and not to his heart. All these supervisors, just please stand on these supervisors. Let's stand on these supervisors. Prayers to him and Lewis. Paula Thompson takes the Northeast first, amen. That's our supervisor, the Bishop James Hornsby. All these women of God, God bless you. Listen, this Kingdom Fellowship Choir is coming, and they're gonna bless us in song. And after they get finished, we've got expressions limited to 2 minutes. We gave the bishops privilege. These next remarks will be limited to 2 minutes. When I stand up, if you're talking, that means you're already 5 seconds over. Is that all right? I don't mean no harm, but 2 minutes. Amen, somebody? Amen. All right, receive it at this time, the Kingdom Fellowship Mass Choir. Amen, by the words of amen. Kingdom Fellowship Mass Choir on this morning. Amen. All right, we're going to allow at this time clergy 2 minutes. They're going to come at this time representing on behalf of the gospel, those who carry the gospel, these clergymen, they can come at this time. Bishop Reginald Williams. Greetings. It's almost afternoon. To the pulpit, the women have been addressed. I won't be long to my friend and brother. Brother Eiland, Superintendent Eiland. I talked to him this week, and I know it's difficult. I lost my wife 4 years ago, come December, and that was a hard jewel to lose. But God will keep you, and you will be all right. Yeah. I heard a story about a little boy that walked up to an old Indian chief and said, "Sir, why do you love the Lord so much?" The chief didn't say anything. He looked around and found a caterpillar and put the caterpillar in the middle of a wooden circle. Then he took some matches and lit the circle until fire was all around. That caterpillar was looking for a way of escape, but couldn't find one. The old Indian chief simply put his hand in the middle of the circle, and the caterpillar climbed on to one of his fingers. And the chief looked back at the little boy and said, "That's why I love him."
he stuck his hand in the middle of the circle. And I climbed on. Ruth Eiland just climbed on. Climb on the finger of the Lord and climb out. Amen. Program calls for a song from the Kingdom Fellowship. What I'm going to do, for the sake of time, we're going to move to resolutions. We'll get a choir song in. Lady Regina Gafford is here. And we've got several resolutions. And we're not going to read them all. We're going to acknowledge those who have come in. There's only a few that will be read in honor of this precious lady and the direction of this family. Ruth Eiland was an amazing young lady. And right at the moment when God was about to, amen, do something spectacular in the life of Prayer Tower Church at another level, he allowed Mother Eiland to transition. And Bishop Cook said something. She won't beat us there, but we will get there at the same time. I don't understand why God took your wife. We were just getting ready to plan another trip. Amen. And well, we were planning, me and her were planning the trip. Because you and Sister Jackson, y'all just show up. But I believe God saved that trip for the final trip. And we all get caught up to glory. So there are several resolutions. We're going to go and read a few of them.
Amen. Good afternoon to everyone. Resolution. And God shall wipe all tears from their eyes. Revelation 7 and 17. Pastor Ruth Trotter Eiland, whereas it has pleased our Heavenly Father in the fulfillment of his universal plan to remove from our midst beloved Pastor Ruth Trotter Eiland. We come with heavy hearts to this final earthly meeting. We are dear for our dear and sainted sister. And whereas hearing of the loss of your beloved Pastor Ruth Trotter Eiland, our hearts are touched. Although saddened by the news, we take comfort in knowing that God knows best. May God's love comfort you. There are so many things on earth that we simply cannot explain. Why one of us is taken, why the rest of us still remain. But until the day we see the Lord and he makes all things clear, we must find comfort in knowing that his love is ever near. Family, be encouraged in the strength of our Lord, Savior Jesus Christ. For our God doth all things well. Whereas during Pastor Eiland's residence in Toledo, Ohio, she and her family were members of New Jerusalem Church of God in Christ, where she served faithfully in ministry for over 6 years. Sister Ruth, as we so affectionately call, was the epitome of a true woman of God, a woman of strong faith in God. You possessed great humor. Never was a dull moment in New Jerusalem. Your laughter was contagious, and it was an honor to be in your presence. God has truly gained another angel. Be it further resolved that Ohio North First Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction family extends our sincere and heartfelt sympathy in your hour of affliction. We further hope that you find a measure of comfort in knowing that Pastor Ruth Trotter Eiland's vivacious spirit will never be forgotten, and that a copy of this resolution remains.
That we believe Pastor Ruth Trotter Eiland was saved and sanctified
and realized the benefits of her preparations in this life and is even now in the presence of the Lord. Servant of God, well done. Rest from thy loved employment. The battle fought, the victory won. Enter thy master's joy. The pains of death are past. Labor and sorrow cease. The long life warfare closed at last. Thy soul is found in peace. Given by our hands this 18th day of March in the year of our Lord, 2023. Bishop Edward T. Cook, Jurisdictional Prelate, Mother Sharon E. Blevins, Jurisdictional Supervisor, and Missionary Viney Smith, the Jurisdictional Secretary. Resolution of respect for Lady Ruth Eiland. There remaineth therefore a rest to the people of God, Hebrews 4 and 9. Heaven will be sweeter and more beautiful, more to be desired because of the entrance through its shining gates of your loved one who left this earth on the 11th day of March, 2023. Let us think of the last and sweetest homecoming in the Father's house of many mansions, where our dear ones are waiting for us. May the blessed Lord come into your hearts more completely, and may we rest our weary souls on him. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, Revelation 14 and 13. Therefore, be it resolved, we assure the family of the deceased that they have our lasting heartfelt sympathy. We bow in acceptance of the perfection of God's plan to gather each of us into his holy, merciful arms when we will have fulfilled our task on earth. That a copy of these resolutions be given to the family and to the press. Be at peace in the everlasting love of the Lord. Respectfully submitted on the 18th day of March, 2023, on behalf of the officers and members of the Straightway Pentecostal Cathedral Church of God in Christ, Bishop T.L. Walker, the pastor, Sister Sharon Harvey, the secretary. Resolution in love and memory of Supervisor Ruth Trotter Eiland, March 18th, 2023. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever believeth in me shall never die. John 11, 25 through 26. Be it known that it has pleased our Heavenly Father to transform from the labors of this life to the sweet rest and fellowship with the saints in heaven. Our dear sister and friend, Supervisor Ruth Trotter Eiland, this resolution comes to express our deepest sympathy in the passing of this amazing woman of God. Whereas we accept that God has done, knowing that all things work together for the good of them that love him, and yet we remember earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Whereas we recognize the transition of this beloved wife, mother, grandmother, sister, and friend is not a loss, but heaven's gain. Supervisor Eiland was strong in her faith, a giant in the gospel, and a steadfast servant of the Lord. She loved her family and her church family. We thank God for the time he allowed her to share this earthly life with us. Inasmuch as we believe the words of Jesus in John 14 that encourages us to let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Be it resolved that she fought a good fight, kept the faith, and finished her course. She has received her reward. We are praying for her husband, our dear brother, Superintendent Roger D. Eiland, and the entire Eiland and Trotter family. God is a very pleasant help in your time of need. Be it resolved that we embrace the Eiland family and the Prayer Tower Church of God in Christ family, because all of us have this common bond that will connect us for the rest of our lives. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy kept in the archives of the West Irving Church of God in Christ. Respectfully and humbly submitted this 18th day of March in the year of our Lord, 2023 AD, Superintendent Andrew and Lady Sandra Jackson, West Irving Church of God in Christ. Resolution in loving memory of Ruth Trotter Eiland. We are today comforted by the words of our Lord in Revelations 21 and 4, which says, "And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. Whereas again a human spirit has taken a flight at the call of the Heavenly Father to the mansion prepared for her from the foundation of this earth by an all-wise loving God, has removed from this earth our classmate and sister in Christ, Mrs. Ruth Trotter Eiland, on this 11th day of March, 2023. Whereas the hearts of the members of her family and her loving friends are sadly torn today, and whereas we realize that in this earthly separation, we see the promise of glorious life to come. Therefore, be it resolved that in the passing of our beloved classmate, Sister Ruth Trotter Eiland, the class of 1976, we have sustained great sorrow. Our classmate, Sister Ruth Trotter Eiland, was a kind and loving person who gave her friendship and her time unselfishly to help others. Be it further resolved that even as we mourn this Sister Eiland, her going away from us, we are resigned to the will of an all-knowing, kind Heavenly Father. We express gratitude to God for having shared with us for a short term the life of Sister Eiland. We express to the family and relatives our deepest sympathy and the reminder that on God's calendar, these trials and crossovers are but for a moment. 2 Corinthians 5, 6 through 8, King James Version says, "Therefore, we are always confident knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith and not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord." Respectfully submitted by the Grenada High School class of 1976. And at this time, Sister Mitchell is coming with the resolution for a prayer tower.
Good afternoon. Though your days among us were too brief, and our grief at your loss is never ending, we draw comfort from the knowledge that you have found safe refuge in the Lord and in our hearts. where no darkness or pain can touch you now. We bless you with love, light, and our gratitude. Whereas it has been the will of the Almighty God to remove from this life a member of our family of faith, Mother Ruth Trotter Eiland, of Prayer Tower Church of God in Christ in Grand Prairie, Texas, on March 11th, 2023. And whereas the transition of Ruth Trotter Eiland does not diminish the profound benediction of a life lived in such godly service, nor our admiration of and affection for Ruth Trotter Eiland's example. And whereas she was a reverent woman who loved the Lord and an amazing person who would perform any task and instilled in her family to follow her example. And whereas she was a mighty prayer warrior, a woman of great faith, a Bible scholar, a powerful preacher, an effective teacher, a praise and worshiper, a songbird, a gracious hostess, a wonderful mentor, a great leader, and an humble servant. And whereas Ruth Trotter Eiland professed a hope in Christ at an early age, and with her husband, Superintendent Roger Eiland, was the founder of Prayer Tower Church of God in Christ in Grand Prairie, where she was a dedicated member, first lady, co-pastor, and mother, and freely gave of her time and energy as a leader and a faithful member of the congregation. And she also served as a supervisor in the Church of God in Christ. And whereas she was a great helpmeet to her husband in the ministry, serving wherever there was a need, be it the Helping Hands Ministry, hospitality, the youth department, Sunday school, women's department, evangelism, or wherever there was a need. And whereas she not only is this the transition of a devoted wife, mother, grandmother, sister, and aunt, but also a confidant, a counselor, and the closest of friends, a person who was always available to share an encouraging word, a beautiful smile, and demonstrate strong support. And this, whereas the transition of our beloved sister is heaven's gain, and there is a human tie that has been broken, which bleeds the heart in agony and pain, we are encouraged and consoled in the words of Jesus, who said, "I will never leave thee nor forsake thee." Therefore, be resolved that we embrace the family, because all of us have a common bond that will connect us for the rest of our lives. We cannot replace Ruth Trotter Eiland, but will attempt to demonstrate her love for you. Be it further resolved that we bow to a greater will than our own and rest in the knowledge that one day we will be united with her again in joy and in the fullness of God's mercy. This is humbly submitted in faith and appreciation for the gift of our time, for the gift of Prayer Tower Church of God in Christ's time with Ruth Trotter Eiland on this March 18, 2023. And this is, of course, acknowledged by Superintendent Roger Eiland of Prayer Tower Church of God in Christ. Prayer Tower loves you.
One
one thing I do know, Bishop Cook, that Prayer Tower loves Superintendent and they love Lady Eiland. I know that for a fact. The Eiland and the Trotter family that traveled from all across. Her brother there, the saxophone great, Brother Trotter. The family just so tight and connected. And I want this family to do a little praying for you. Y'all made an impact on my life years ago. And your sister, your auntie, your cousin, always will be in our hearts. Mother Lewis could not be here today. Mother Barbara Lewis. Amen.
Intentionally sent to represent her from the National Church, to
represent her for the Mary Bond, Supervisor of Texas Northwest Jurisdiction. And she's come with a special resolution on behalf of the Department of Women, the Church of God in Christ.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Certainly the house has already been addressed, but I do give deference and respect to this great presiding bishops and to Superintendent Trotter, to Superintendent Eiland, and to the family. God bless you. I'm going to ask all the supervisors, my sisters, if you will stand at this time. On behalf of the International Department of Women, Church of God in Christ Incorporated, Mother Barbara McCoo Lewis, General Supervisor, Mother Willie Mae Rivers, General Supervisor Emerita, Bishop J. Drew Shear, Presiding Bishop and Chief Apostle. Condolence to Superintendent Roger Eiland and the family of Mother Ruth Eiland, Supervisor without charge. Give her of the fruit of her hands and let her own works praise her. Proverbs 31 and 31. On behalf of the International Department of Women, Church of God in Christ Incorporated, we bow our heads in humble submission as we accept the sovereign will of the Almighty God, our Father, who is, in his infinite wisdom, has called from this earthly place our precious love one, Mother Ruth Eiland. Inasmuch as we try, words are simply inadequate to express the sadness felt. We know that sorrow and grief are a must in this life. Therefore, we are praying for you and asking God to comfort you and comfort your hearts, to ease your grief with, as you have the precious memories of Mother Eiland. Be consoled by reflecting on the multitude of lives enriched by the beautiful love given, the love that she received, and the godly principles that Mother Eiland exemplified with a lasting legacy to many, for many to follow. Our hearts grieve and yet rejoice at the same time, as we know Mother Eiland is now safely home at last, because the moment of absence here is the moment of presence with the Lord, and she has entered the greatest of rewards. In the fellowship of this faith, we extend to you our love and continued prayers. Remember, earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. It is our prayer that you celebrate your life as you hold fast to the memories which you hold dear, accepting what God has allowed. We pray that you will find comfort in the words of our Lord, Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Proverbs 30:5. Prayerfully submitted this 15th day of March in the year of our Lord, 2023. Mother Barbara McCool Lewis, General Supervisor. Mother Dr. Wilma J. Huey, First Assistant General Supervisor. Mother Vanessa Winbush Gatlin, Second Assistant General Supervisor. Mother Mary Jane Walton, Third Assistant General Supervisor. We will present this condolence to you.
Thank you, Supervisor Barnes. It's an honor to have the General Supervisor present such a wonderful resolution on behalf of this great body of women of the Church of God in Christ. We celebrate our women of this great church. And if they leave the church, I'm going right with them. Hey, I love you brothers, but I'm going with the women. Amen, amen. Thank you, Supervisor Barnes. Thank you again. Kathy Wilson is coming at this time. Kathy Wilson, for reading of obituary. We'll be right back for the few remarks from the family. At this time, receive Kathy Wilson.
The Life Reflections of Ruth Trotter Eiland. Ruth Elizabeth Trotter was born March 2nd, 1958 to the late Ulysses and Selma Trotter. She was born into a family of 15 children, 11 girls and 4 boys, with her being the 9th child. Ruth graduated from high school in Grenada School District in Grenada, Mississippi, and later attended Toledo University in Toledo, Ohio. Ruth was an employee of Southwestern Bell, also known as AT&T, and retired as a manager after 31 years. She married the love of her life, Roger D. Eiland, on July 15, 1978. Together, they attended Pilgrim's Rest Church of God in Christ in Oakland, Mississippi. AT&T transferred her work to Toledo, Ohio, where she attended the New Jerusalem Church of God in Christ. Years later, AT&T then transferred her to Dallas, Texas in 1994, where she and her family attended Saintsville Sanctuary Church of God in Christ. Ruth accepted Christ at the young age of 12 under the tutelage of Bishop J. Newell Haynes in 1996. She helped her husband establish Prayer Tower Church of God in Christ in their garage of their home. They later obtained a building on Spike Street in Grand Prairie, Texas. During her tenure as First Lady, she was elevated to co-pastor of the church and faithfully served in several capacities. In 2017, she was elevated to state supervisor for the Texas Metropolitan Jurisdiction. Ruth was a devoted wife and mother of 3 children, Roger Brandon Eiland and his wife Rachel, Stephanie Latasha Dixon and her husband Courtney, Brittany Tierra Robinson and her husband Jordan. She was also the mother to her niece, Clatina Gail Wright and her husband Lamont. She was a doting and ever-present in her 12 grandchildren's lives. There was never anything the grands wanted and they couldn't have. She loved to host family gatherings, church parties, and greeted her guests with 5 to 7 course meals. She had meticulous organizational skills, and she usually planned all of her family annual vacation cruises. Mother Eiland was preceded in death by her family, by her parents, Ulysses and Selmer Trotter, three sisters, Betty Ingram, Mary Starks, Gilmer Williams, and her two brothers, Anthony Trotter and Ulysses Bud Trotter. She is survived by her husband, Superintendent Roger D. Eiland, her children and grandchildren, TJ, Trey, Wiley, Brooklyn, Ariana, Harmony, Jai, Leia, C2, Preston, London, and Elijah. She also leaves her seven sisters, Patricia Lynch of Oakland, California, Dorothy Trotter of Chicago, Illinois, Regina Williams of Batesville, Mississippi, Vernetta Doris of Lancaster, California, Dorcas and her husband Arthur Tucker of San Leandro, California, Brenda Trotter of Grenada, Mississippi, Stephanie and her husband Davidez Dampierre of York, Pennsylvania, her three brothers, Leslie Thomas and of Smyrna, Georgia, Richard and Maureen Trotter of Grand Prairie, Texas, Dexter and his wife Bernice Trotter of Grenada, Mississippi, and a host of nieces, nephews, cousins, and her Prayer Tower Church family.
Thank you, Kathy. I applied for a job in Southwestern Bell in 1976. They didn't hire me. I wasn't good enough, so they hired Ruth instead. What a wonderful life that she lived. Amen. Give it up again for that wonderful life. Family tributes coming at this time. If you're coming, please come and brothers coming, Brother Trotter, a member of Saintsville Church of God in Christ. Mr. Hornsby is the pastor. The sisters are coming. Now, I know the sister, I know that one right there is like to have church, so I'm going to time you. I'm talking about you again. She was kind of preaching up in here.
Good afternoon. I'd like to give reverence to all our bishop, my pastor, Bishop Hornsby, and thank you for everything you've done for our family and all of the other bishops. Amen. I thank you all. I'm the next to the youngest. We all give ourselves numbers, and I'm number 14. And I just want to say, and I'll make it real short, because I said I wasn't going to say anything because I know it's going to be kind of tough for me. It's all right. Ruth was my... not only my sister, she was my neighbor. In Elder Island, you know, they lived across the street from me, and, you know, part of their, what he said, that AT&T transfer. No, I begged her to come to move to Texas because I didn't have any family out here. And they moved, and I really appreciated having a sister across the street. You know, sometimes she would try to be of a more of a mother than a sister. And I had to learn one thing, you know, she got me in trouble with my wife. It was a Thanksgiving. And, you know, they lived across the street. And my wife was cooking Thanksgiving dinner. And Ruth was cooking Thanksgiving dinner. And my wife was a little slow. So I went across the street just to see what they had. And I came back with crumbs on my mouth. And so my wife looked at me and I had to eat twice. I'm going to miss Ruth. You know, we grew up in a big family. We got a host of nieces and nephews here. I prepared food for them yesterday, and I ain't gonna do it again. But I really thank every one of you who supported us, and Roger, at Eiland Superintendent. You know, we've been there, you know. I don't know how long y'all were married, but I'm right across the street, and you know, anything you need, I'm there for you. And Stephanie, Tierra, Roger, Tina, and I don't know all of the Leia. I don't know all of the grandkids' names, I'm gonna get them mixed up, but I'm right across the street, and y'all pray for us and pray for the family. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm number 15. I'm the last of the, what they said, Mohicans, but I give honor to everyone that's here. I thank God for the island, my brother-in-law, more like a brother. Amen. Thank God for my sister Ruth. And we had some good times on those cruises. She would plan those cruises, and I would look forward to going to those cruises every year. And the last couple times I couldn't make it, I look at the pictures and I told my wife, I said, we ain't gonna make it. But, you know, we would look at the pictures and they would have such a good time. And every time we would go out to eat, Ella Island and Sister Island, no, I had five children, I had all girls. And so Ella Island would tell me, you can get whatever you want, we got you. And he said, you don't have to just get a hamburger. But I like hamburgers, so I still get a hamburger. But they would always take care of us. And every time we went somewhere, since I was the youngest, Ruthie used to always buy me clothes, her and my other sister, Dorcas. And I'd get mad at her. I'd go and they'd buy me a toy, I'd tear it up. A few days later, she come with another toy. But they had spoiled me, so I was the youngest, but I'm gonna miss her. And I just want the rest of the family to know, Tierra, Stephanie, Tina, all of y'all, we love y'all, and we ain't going nowhere, we still here. Amen. Y'all pray for us.
I just want to say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I won't complain. God has been good to me. He's been so good to me. More than this world could ever be. Bathroom, because you know that's my, I love to clean. Yeah. So
I had that bathroom looking like it was brand new. They got a big old bathroom. Lord Jesus. I was in there for 2 hours, 3 hours. And she said, and I want you to fix my hair. I did her hair, and boy, she looked so beautiful. So when we went to the visitation yesterday.
Careful.
Huh?
Careful.
So, be quiet, Stephanie. So when I looked down, and, you know, I'm a beautician, so I want her to, you know, they didn't have that part, but I fixed that part. She looked so pretty when I got down with the house. This was to my satisfaction. I did something I never thought I'd do. I loved her, and I'm going to continue to love her. I'm going to go because there's some big old sisters back there in mine. But I am number 10.
My sweet brother-in-law, to his children, to my sisters and brothers. I thank God for my sister Ruth. I'm number three. I'm number three. We had a really hard time coming up. But by the time Ruthie was a teenager, she was working. So she was really blessed. Amen. And I remember I'm the mother of nine. 6 boys and 3 girls. And Elder Eiland, before they had children, what I thank God for them for, she said, if anything would ever happen to you and your husband, we'll take all of your children. So if anything had happened to us, I wasn't worried because I would know that they would take care of them. And many times my children would need something sometime. There was some time they'd need something. I said, well, go to your rich aunt and uncle and ask them. So I love God. She flew to my 75th yes. birthday celebration. Yes. She made sure she was going to be there, and we was with her. I love her. We will never, never, never forget her. Amen. And you and your children, Ella Eiland, I'm here. I'm number 7. I used to sign my emails number 7. People didn't know what that meant. I want to say that Ruth and I grew up very close. I was her big sister, because she was the next girl to me. We had the same cars. We bought the same cars. We worked at the same company, AT&T. We married preachers. We decorated our living room just alike. I didn't know that until 3 years later. I said, all this stuff in your living room is just like mine, even this flower. Mine is just pink and yours is green. We had the same taste in a lot of things. She would buy the same clothes as I bought and the same color. I said, Ruth, get a different color so you can switch them up. So we just did a lot of things. I remember when she wrote her first check, she called me. She came over, she said, can you show me how to write this check? And I showed her. And we did a lot of things. We'd go to the convocation together. Before their husbands came, I would fly from California and they would all stay in our room, me and my husband's room. And me and my sisters had a great time. I don't care how many of them it was. We all came in together. We stayed in the same room, some of them sleeping in the bathtub, but we did that at the hotel. I want to say that when Ruth moved to Texas though, Ruth became like a metamorphosis. She blossomed into somebody different. She began to plan things, and she became a co-pastor. She became a supervisor, and she no longer needed me in that capacity. But I'm thanking God that whenever I needed her, I could call her. I was told her when she was a teenager, you make a good little pastor's wife. I said, I don't want no parts of it. But I praise God today for Ruth.
I just had one thing to say to my brother-in-law. You always be my brother-in-law.
Yeah.
I know the plans I have for you, said the Lord.
Just that.
I know the plans I have for you. I know just what you're going through. Because see, I've been there too. But when you can't see what tomorrow holds, and yesterday is through, he said, I know the plans I have for you. So when you can't see what tomorrow holds, yesterday is through.
Praise God for being here, to all the bishops and pastors, to my brother, Pastor Roger, to everyone in the room. Ruthie came to see me.
Yes.
My husband and I pastored for 30 years in California,
yes,
but he passed on also.
Yes.
And she came to see me. She would come take care of me. I remember when I was sick and I had to go have a major surgery.
Yes.
She must have came and stayed about 2.5 weeks,
yes,
taking care of me,
yes,
after that surgery.
Yes.
I'll always be thankful and, yes, grateful for her.
Yes.
Amen.
It's
all right.
It's all right.
Thankful. Amen. This is my son, Bishop Darrell Dorris.
Yes.
Come on, clap your hands, everybody. Come on, tell the Lord thank you. Come on, y'all. Tell the Lord thank you. I want to say to my uncle saw me when I was first starting off pastoring. And I was in a little church no bigger than this pulpit. And he encouraged me so much. I'd never forget, we was talking about praise and worship. And after that, when my aunt came out, and I'm going to say this because I hope I don't embarrass you, Pastor, Superintendent Roger. When she became supervisor in 2016, my wife became assistant supervisor in 2017. And they kept kicking her out the room because my wife was young and they thought that she was an armor bearer. And so she called. And she looks younger than what she is also. And Mother Lewis, she had to go get Mother Lewis. We're from California. And so I remember Aunt Ruthie was talking to her. She said, "Baby, don't worry about them old women. You're gonna be all right. Just go in there and look pretty. You're gonna be fine." My wife was like, "They keep putting me out. I don't know what else to do. I can't take the class." But I had a situation, bishops, at my church. I had a prophetess that decided that she was going to be the next first lady. And that year that she came out to help my mother, Aunt Ruth had preached for me that Sunday night. And so my wife, she's a sweet woman. My wife is very sweet. And Aunt Ruth, and she didn't even tell her who she was. And Supervisor Eiland zeroed in on her. My wife's nickname is Pumpkin. She said, "Come here, Pumpkin. Is that devil right there?" Uncle Roger, this is God's truth. And my wife got the spirit of the living God. It came in her, and they double-teamed that woman, and she's no longer a member in my church, thank God. But that's the type of woman Aunt Ruth was, and I just thank God for her, y'all. Come on, can we celebrate my auntie? Amen. God bless you. From Living Faith Cathedral, we love you. We love you.
Thank you.
number 12. And my number 11 is the one, Brenda, that got him sing that song. She's the one that used to aggravate me. But Ruth spoiled me. And I'm trying not to cry, so y'all pray for me. Ruth was just a phenomenal woman. I remember when she came to my house and stayed a couple of weeks, she just said she just needed to get away. And she told me, I said, well, Ruth, I can't take off work all this time. And she said, girl, don't worry about me. She said, I'm just gonna be here, I'm gonna be praying. She said, you and David go to work, because it was just, you know, we up the nesters. And I came back home one day and she said, girl, I had prayer in here today. It was a different atmosphere than y'all could feel it when I walked in the room. She was a prayer warrior. She was a prayer warrior. She said, I prayed, I went to every room, and I anointed every room with blessed oil. And wasn't nobody in the room, but that's fine. I said, honey, keep on praying and keep on anointing, because we need the Holy Ghost up in here. And I thank God for her. I thank God for her husband, Roger. We love you. Children, we love you. TT, we love you. Tina, Stephanie, Roger, and the son-in-laws, we love all of you. And I just want to say, when I see Jesus, amen. When I see the one who died for me, the one who set me free,
together. Yes. When she brought home that little baby, Ruthie called me and she said, I got her. I came home with her and they're all three together. Yes. You know, Ruthie was one of 15. I'm one of 12. And I didn't know anybody could have more than 12 children. But Aunt Selma showed my mama up. She had 15 of them. I remember once when Ruthie and Richard came to the house with their little bitty children. My husband had just planted a little tree in the backyard. And the kids went out and they were playing. And they came back in. Richard came in and he said, Ruthie, your children and broke that tree. Ruthie said, well, how do you know my children broke it? Yo, you got some bad children too. He's very meticulous about his yard. And he came home and that tree would lean down, but he didn't do anything but go out there and put some stakes in the ground and try and straighten it back up. But we laughed about that. I just want y'all to know that God is with you. The Bible tells us that, you know, even in the valley of the shadow of death, fear no evil, for I am with thee. Ruth is all right. She's all right. And so will you be too. Richard, God said he would never leave us nor forsake us. So for whatever we're going through, God is there with us. We've traveled this road before. We've seen our siblings go on before us. God, all we have to do is look at history. God has brought us through, and he'll continue to do that. I love you, Trotter. Brother Eiland, I've never met you, but I know my cousin loved you dearly. Be at peace, family. You'll be okay. God bless you. Oh, wait a minute, I need to tell y'all something else too. All of them Trotters got some talents. They can sing, and we used to often tell my mama, it's 12 of us, why can't we sing? They won't even let me sing in the choir unless it's Woman Sunday, and then they can't stop me. God bless you.
Amen, amen. These last two representing the nieces and nephews.
This is hard for me, but I am the daughter of number five. I'm Maypop's daughter, and I am the second oldest grandchild, the oldest niece. The first one is in California, so he didn't really count. So I got to be real spoiled because the mothers wasn't there yet. And when Aunt Ruth met Uncle Roger and they said, Aunt Ruth getting married, I was flabbergasted. Some other people were there. When I was growing up, they were always the fun uncle, auntie and uncle. You wanted to go with them. You wanted to be around them. They was gonna tell you what was right, but you was gonna have a good time too. You was gonna have some good food too. When she moved away, I was really sad. And I said, Uncle Roger, you took my auntie. But as I got older, I understood. And when my mom got sick, Maypop, yes. And Ruthie came, she packed her stuff and she said, I'm on my way. She made a vigil. She was a prayer warrior. Yes. She stood on her faith, yes, and her word. And it's hard for me. Yes. When my mom passed, she said, me and Uncle Roger got you. Christmas didn't go back, and my children didn't have something from an auntie and an uncle that was really a grandmom and granddaddy, yeah, because she knew that my mom would have done the same thing. She called me and said, pray for me. She said, I'm praying for you. How's it going? If I was having a rough day, she said, I'm on it. If I sent her a text and I said, today is just one of them days, she said back, I got you. And it wasn't even 5 minutes, it seemed like. It just started getting bright. But that was just the miracle of Aunt Ruth. It was her aura. It was her personality. It was her everything. And knowing that I can't just text her real quick, and all my aunts are special. All my aunties and uncles are special. But we had a special relationship.
That's right.
And she was like my other mom. And so it feels like losing my mama again. Okay. And I love her. I love my cousins. We like sisters and brothers.
Yes.
Y'all pray for us.
I'm the second oldest of number three of the Trotter clan. I do appreciate your patience with us today. Thank God for all of our, the bishops and the ladies, the supervisors, and to Uncle Roger. This is hard for us. This is tough because she was just at my church a couple of weeks ago, she and Elder Allen. This was our second mama, literally. Uncle Roger, our second father. Uncle Roger declares, I take none of his advice. He said, I talk to Korea, and he goes the opposite direction. I do take your advice. I just do it a different way. I celebrate her, because she literally
had taken on mom's children as hers. No summer hardly went without that we weren't at their house. During the time they were in Toledo. That is how I got to know Elder Cook, because we worshiped at his church. At least I did, because I was there during that summer. And all during that time, we learned, we gained, and this is why we're here now, because a woman like Aunt Ruth, her name is even powerful by itself. Yes. Somebody say the name.
Ruth.
Thank you.
God bless you, Pastor Craig. There was a connection between the Trotter Eiland family because they serve in the same jurisdiction where my sister and her husband serve as superintendent in northern Mississippi. God bless you. Roger's coming, the son. The children are coming, and they're gonna be the last three, but then Pastor Eiland is coming to close it out. Amen. They tried to protect him from saying anything, but he said, I gotta say something. So receive these wonderful children, and then finally, let's stand when Pastor Eiland approaches the podium in honor of his wonderful wife. With 15 children, they all got to hang on in here because they got a big family. Amen.
First of all, thank everyone today for coming out. We appreciate all the love and support that's present in this room. Like Bishop Cook, I don't know. I've been racking my brain all week thinking of what I was going to say. And I'm normally very articulate and good with words. But I don't have any today that I could write down on paper. I was up at 1:30 this morning or so, and I told my wife I didn't want to go to sleep because the next time I opened my eyes, I'd be at my mama's funeral. And none of this seemed real. Looking at the program and seeing all the family. But I heard y'all, I saw her dancing around earlier, and I thought, I don't have it in me. But I know that's exactly what she would have wanted and what she would have been doing too. So while I didn't have it in me to do it, I'm glad y'all was about y'all praying for me. And I looked over for a moment, and I said, I could see her jump on out of that thing and start dancing. You know, I heard a lot of people talk about how she's a prayer warrior today. Prayer warriors need practice. And that's where we came in. She got a lot of practice. Prayer for these kids up here. I think we didn't have iPhones back then, but I think I would have been, the principal's office was in her favorites list when I was in school. I think she spent many a days up there protecting me, defending me, or trying to figure out why I did something. It got to a point where the spankings and the switches, they just didn't work. So she came up with an idea. I'm gonna put them on the stairs, because I was just always into something, this and that. And she said, I think they had a family meeting or something, but they decided to put me on the stairs and make me read books. And to this day, I thank my mom for that. And I'm gonna tell you one more story. So I had another loved one pass in a similar fashion on my wife's side recently, about 6 or 7 months ago, I think. Is that about right? About a year ago. And I texted my dad, I texted my mom, and I said, that was the hardest thing I don't ever want to see that happen to y'all. And fast forward, and it was the exact same situation. And it was a fear of mine. But reflecting on it this week, I learned a lot about my mom. Being with her the last 2 weeks and with the family this past week. She was determined. She was full of faith. And just reflecting on the diagnosis that she was given and what they said, what's gonna happen, and none of it played out that way. She was flying here and there. She was going wherever she wanted to go. Cruise, she went on a cruise, y'all. And I'm reading, going, Googling, I'm looking. I'm like, she must be gone. None of it adding up. And I think God's hand was over her, and I know that she had some things on her checklist that she wanted to do. And on her birthday, we was worried, you know, she's gonna be able to make it to the party that she was so excited to have. And I walked out on her birthday and I said, "You made it." She looked at me and said, she knew what she wanted to do, and I think she had the strength, and God gave her the nod to do exactly what she wanted to do and check those things off her list. And on her birthday, on her party, she just had a glow about her. I mean, y'all, some of y'all were there, y'all saw her. She just had a glow. And it was beautiful. I could just see God's presence over her and giving her the strength to do have that last birthday. So I thank my mom. She taught us how to be spouses,
yes.
How to be parents. She was parents to some of y'all out there, like that's mentioned a moment ago. And she's got other extra children out here in the crowd, right? You got, I mean, she got a big family, and not to mention the big family, but there's another side of it. And she, I mean, she was just an amazing woman. And we don't miss her. But she talked about, I mean, she preached about, she sang about, she danced about, all that. She was all about God. And so, I forget who mentioned it earlier, but she got a better deal. I think it was Pastor Jackson that said that. She got a better deal. So I'm just so thankful for her in our lives and all the impact she had on everyone in this crowd today.
Roger basically summed up everything, so I'm not going to take too much time. I am like my mom when it comes to writing down everything. So all week I was thinking, I need to say something. What am I going to say? But I never could write anything. So just sitting here, I just want to say thank you. There's some really important people who helped us. Mother Evelyn is one. If I forget you guys, I'm so sorry. But Mother Evelyn is someone who really, really helped her. Cousin Charlotte, I thank you for being there for me to call you, to text you, to ask you anything. My sister, everyone thinks of how I was there for the last 2 weeks, but our sister took care of her for the last 7 months. She moved in with her to make sure that she was good. Everyone talks about how strong my mother was. In those last 2 weeks, I saw a whole new definition of strong.
Yes.
And even in that, well, the day she got out of the hospital, we all went to the house, and everybody got ready to leave. And I said, she said, "Stephanie, you leaving?" I said, "No, I'm not going nowhere." She said, "You staying?" I said, "Yes, ma'am." She said, "I need you." And she said, "Courtney gonna let you stay?" And I said, "Yes, ma'am." And she said, "I love him." If you know her, she made catfish and spaghetti. She said, "Tell Courtney, I'm gonna make him some fish and spaghetti." So even in that, she wouldn't let me take London to daycare. She wanted London in that house. And you see in some of these pictures, London was right there doing everything with her. She was when her hospital bed came the last few days, she was in the bathtub and she said, "London, won't y'all?" Everything. It was just London, London. Make sure you take care of London. And so even with my mom being strong, I learned another strength, and that strength was my father. Dad, you were there. You heard, you saw everything that we didn't see. And you were the strength when nobody was around to be the strength. And now it's our turn to be your strength. And we love you.
Give it up for these wonderful children. Sent food over to the house yesterday. Thank you so much. To my best friend, Superintendent Jackson. Yeah. Amen. And Superintendent Cluckley, I want to tell people that I couldn't answer phone calls. But I heard every message. I heard every text. I just couldn't answer. Superintendent Cluckley and Superintendent Jackson stepped in for me. And I certainly want to thank God for Bishop T.L. Walker, the servant of the Lord. Yeah. Mother Walker, thank God for you. I want to thank God for every person in the room. One of the things that I really understand is this. We have a cliche that we say, don't give them their flowers after they're gone. But I can say just about everybody in this room gave my wife flowers before she left here. Because you sent texts, you prayed for her, you loved her. And I want to say, Mother Parker, even when my wife stepped down as supervisor, her Mother Lewis asked her to remain as a supervisor without charge. You always respected her. Whenever we came into the room, you would send one of your adjutant ladies back there to kill her and say, you still a supervisor, come to the front. We really appreciate that as a family. She would try to sit in the back because she never wanted to be up front. But you would always tell her, no, you're still a supervisor, and bring her up front. If we were at a table or a dinner or something, Mother Parker, you would say, you're still a supervisor, you save space for her. So those were her flowers before today. And I appreciated that. I don't know if Missionary Richardson is here from Metropolitan under Bishop Williams. Whenever we went to a meeting, Missionary Richardson would find Sister Ina and find a place for her to sit with the supervisors. So you kept her and she knew that you loved her. She appreciated that. So I wanted to thank everybody because you didn't just wait for them. And there's a young man here, he's not a bishop or superintendent or anybody, but it's Pastor Renfro. He lost his brother the same day as my wife, but he's here singing in the choir. So I want to acknowledge him. And we are praying together. God is going to bless you. I want to say about my wife, the reason why it's so hard is because when a person is such a loving person like she was, it is hard to let that go. And I say it in the writing, I know deep down in my heart that she's with the Lord, and I really want to be happy. I can't be happy right now.
But I know she with the Lord.
Yes.
I want to tell Superintendent Jackson something. my kids already know. He's my best friend, but he don't know this part. I think Superintendent Jackson loves my other friend, Pastor Thompson. After so long, don't touch me no more. I was at church last Sunday before last. And we had about 8 preachers that they're with me. And I started a little crying, and they started patting on me. And I said, I'm good. And I kept on patting, and I said, I'm good. And finally I asked them, don't touch me.
They saw it on Facebook.
Oh, they said they saw it on Facebook. And especially don't touch my head. So one of them was rubbing my head, and I said, nobody rubbed my head but my wife. So. And it wasn't that I was being mean. It's just when a person is crying and you keep rubbing them and patting them, you can't stop crying. So I just needed you, don't touch right now. And he's my best friend, so he's gonna stay right here. But I want to say this about my wife, is, as they have said, that she is a person that just doesn't do anything. She has to plan it, and it has to be done. And so everything that we've done in the 44 years, a little more than 44 years, that we've been married, my wife has planned every step of the way. And she plans it so in such detail until I just, Bishop Jackson, I just relent to whatever she wants to do. When we go on the trip, I knew I was a grown man, but she had my passport. She had all the children's passport. And when we got to get ready to get on the ship, she had handed out to us. When we got on the ship, she wanted them all back. That way she knew that everything would be in order and nobody would be left. So I just handed it back like a good husband would do. But what she taught me is that if you plan, you won't fail. So she and I talked about this when they gave her the diagnosis. She was not supposed to live this long. But she cried the day that they gave her the diagnosis, and then she wiped her tears and she didn't cry anymore. And she said to me, honey, I'm gonna live. And I believed her. And we started studying about healing.
I got real deep into healing.
And I understood what healing was. Healing is a spiritual thing and not a physical thing. And we talked about it, that she was healed the moment she said she was healed. Matter of fact, Bishop Cook alluded to it a little bit. She was healed when she got saved.
That's right.
Because salvation and healing are the same thing. If you read through the Bible, the day you get saved, God gives you your healing. And so she was healed. So we never believed that we would be standing here today. And I couldn't understand why we were going to stand here today. So last Sunday morning, I did not sleep well. And I got up about 4 o'clock in the morning. And my wife has a calendar in the bedroom. She has a calendar in our family room. And she has a calendar in the bathroom. And on that calendar, she has written down everything that she's going to do that day for the rest of the year. And I looked at that calendar, and there was a place on that calendar.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. And she had scribbled out, and she changed her mind and said she was going to do something else. And when I saw that, God said to me in my spirit, she didn't give up.
She changed the plan.
That's it. That's it.
And I understood why she changed the plan. Because Sis Eiland was a servant. And she served people all the time. And one of the things that she couldn't understand is that myself and my children loved her so much until we would do anything. And one day when we was helping her, she said, "I am so sorry y'all have to do this." And we tried to explain to her, "This is what we want to do because of all that you've done for us." But she could not accept that we were serving her because she was a servant in our heart. So I believe she changed the plan. Because she couldn't accept being served. As you heard her sister say, when anybody had surgery, she flew there. Didn't matter where they were, she flew to where they were. So she was just a servant in her heart. So this is what she would want me to do today. She would want me to talk to my children. Because the last Sunday she was at church, she called me to the side. She said, "Make sure and tell my children how much I appreciate what they have done." And I was trying to do it, and I guess I didn't do it enough, and she told me, "Bring me the mic." So she could recognize her children. So let me recognize my children, our children. As my daughter Stephanie said, Tierra, she moved in with us. We didn't want her to move in. She called us and said, "Dad, you and Mom gonna need some help, because both of y'all are sick." And I said, "No, we good. We don't need no, we y'all moved out. We don't need anybody to come back." And so she said, I said, "Well, just stay where you are, you and your husband.
Just stay where you are."
And so the very next day, a storm came. And Tierra sent me a picture, her roof that caved in. It was on a Sunday. She said, "I'll be moving in." Ruth and I went to church that Sunday, and Tierra moved in by the time we got out of church. She moved in, the garage was full. I couldn't put my car in the garage. I don't know how she got everything done that quick, but she has a business mind like her mother. And she moved in, and I found out that it was a good thing that she did. Because every time my wife called Tierra, she was right there. She ran as quick as she could to get to my wife. And then we figured out that we didn't have to do all the things that we had been doing. So we would sit in our recliners and she would be in her room. We would call on the cell phone, "Tierra, can you go get us some ice cream?" She never complained and she just went and done it. So thank you, Tierra. Again, when she had to go to the hospital and she got out of the hospital, as Stephanie said, she came. And Stephanie has not left. She's still there, and her husband is there, and the kids. All of them came, and all of them moved in. They still have their houses, but they are all living in my house. So my daughter-in-law, Rachel, asked me the other day, she said, "Dad, how does it feel to have all your children back home and their spouses and the children?" I said, "Crowded." But my wife did not feel the same way. She told me she liked to hear the footsteps, she liked to hear the noise. I don't like a lot of noise. But because my wife said she liked the noise, I accepted the noise. So now that's why you see me retreat to my room sometimes. And they think I'm just back there crying. But I talk to my wife and tell her what's going on. I don't be crying all the time. I see them ease in the room. They come and check on me. They sit there. I say, "I just want to spend some time with myself." I have the best children. And I thank God that my wife raised them well. When my son was little, we called him Little Roger. But now I'm Little Roger. But my wife, she said, "I don't want to hurt you." She said, "Call Roger." I said, "Baby, I can pick you up." She said, "Call Roger." So I called Roger. And he just does it with ease. I think she just wanted her son to do it. So I'm thankful. There's another young man that everybody always thought was my son. But he is my son. That's Brother Dennis right there. And they live in Austin, Texas now. They were members of Prayer Tower, but they still been there tied to Prayer Tower when they come. Kathy and Dennis are married. That was the young lady that did be. So I thank God for her. Thank God for them. I love my Prayer Tower family. They have been such a wonderful blessing. A wonderful blessing to you. My wife and my family, we thank God for you. Y'all are awesome. And we appreciate you and thank God for every one of you. I know y'all do. Bishop Hornsley, I had to be like Moses. They were bringing so much food to the house, I had to call and say, don't bring any more food. They brought it every day. And I told them on Tuesday, don't bring no more until Thursday. And they did that, and it's still too much. So Missionary Williams has six boys. And we got to thinking, if those all those boys come, we can get rid of this food. All of them are here. And so they came, some of them came by yesterday, and I said, please, please take some of this food with you. And my sisters packed it up for them, and they took it, and we still have plenty of food. So I want all six boys to come by today. My wife has a huge family. And I thank God for him. I want one more person, then I'm gonna sit down. Our pastor in Mississippi is here. I didn't see him until just now. Yeah. Will you please stand, Pastor Elmer Brown? He was our pastor in Mississippi, and I certainly appreciate him. Matter of fact, some people say I preach like him. I guess I had to. That's where I got called to preach under his leadership. So I guess we take after our father in the gospel. So I thank God for Pastor L.B. O'Brien, Jr., Oakland, Mississippi, Pilgrim Rest Church of God in Christ. Thank God for you. He was under Bishop P.T. Scott, and he was the state evangelist there. And I would be so proud of my pastor when we would go to the state meeting. He would play that trumpet. He would sing, and he would preach. Yes. And I don't care, whoever was sitting by me, I would just touch him and say, that's my pastor. Then I said, that ain't good enough. I said, we first cousins, too. So my pastor is my first cousin, and I thank God for him. I really thank God for all these bishops there. I know y'all didn't have to take time to come, but I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I thank you, I thank you. Thank the choir. Appreciate all of you. Thank you, Superintendent Clerk, for letting me take some of your time. Bless you. Thank you so much.
They can only invite family members, Prayer Tower members, and members of the clergy to the fellowship hall for the repast. Since Brother Eiland always wanted everyone to leave with something, Prayer Tower is providing boxed refreshments for all others. Thank you, and please keep the family lifted in prayer. Please understand that they're wanting to feed the immediate family and the church members. Others of you, with all due respect, if you allow them to have that moment, and there is food prepared as you do that. Amen. And again, please understand, I lost some sleep trying to get ready. Nervous, scared, reading, writing, writing, and reading. But it would just be so wrong after the children and after this husband has expressed himself. And I think leaving on a spiritual note would be greater than. I do honor my bishop. Each one of you, I give you the highest honor and respect. But it's just
let's God bless Superintendent Michael Clerkley. What a wonderful, mighty man of God. And I want to appreciate you, Mr. Superintendent Eiland, Superintendent Clerkley, for standing beside Superintendent Eiland during these times, being the buffer to handle those phone calls. God bless you. Superintendent Eiland, wonderful. The internment will be Tuesday. The internment will be Tuesday. What time is the internment? 11 o'clock. The Grand Prairie Memorial Gardens. That's in Grand Prairie, Texas. Pastor Superintendent Dexter Lewis and Pastor Michael Arthur Thompson, please give this to your brother. There's a special gift that was Pastor Thompson. It's a special gift for you from us, and that's for you from Pastor Thompson, Dexter Lewis, Pastor Lewis, Superintendent Lewis, and myself. Well, we didn't ask for this. We are traveling buddies, Bishop. Adjutant Brother, this is from Bishop Wells for you, Pastor Eiland. Superintendent Eiland, Bishop Wells. We're not raising an offer, we just want to give you something because we travel a lot and a lot of times y'all take care of a lot of us on these cruises. And we're appreciating your wife and being so kind to us. Well, this has been a wonderful celebration. This has been a wonderful celebration. All these bishops here today. My cousin, they call him my cousin, Bishop Jackson, Superintendent Clerkley, Bishop Walker. God bless you. President of this jurisdiction, Bishop Wells, Mr. Cook. God bless you. We're praying for you. Mr. Reginald Wells, my leader, my bishop, Mr. James E. Hornsby. Let's all stand, and I want this choir. Is it a solo? All right, that's a solo. All right, all the way from. This is the family member. Amen. Y'all sit down. I know what I'm doing. I know what I'm doing. This young man gonna wreck the house. Y'all already know it, don't you? It's a family member. Let's receive Carlos Johnson.
He just doesn't say, oh, ho, 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 oh, Lord. Without
from the Anderson brothers or sisters to stand by the family. Because the Anderson brothers and sisters stand by the family. We're going to expedite the recessional. We don't want to belabor them by stopping and shaking their hands. Amen. In the hands of our fellow directors. He brought me from a man.
Thank you.
time to do the committal service. Let me make this quick announcement. Someone in a black Mercedes GL350. You're in a black Mercedes GL350. They say your lights are flashing. You have a Mercedes, a black Mercedes GL350. For as much as it has pleased the Almighty God to take out of this world our deceased mother, we convert her body to Mother Earth, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Looking for the joy of resurrection and the last day of the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming and glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible body shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Would you repeat after us, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen. And I heard the voice of heaven saying unto me, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from henceforth. And yea, said the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. Grace and the peace of God be with you as we begin to exit. Go with God, and God bless you.